So we have seen before break what is the star delta transformation. Okay, so in a star delta transformation, the first topic was star to delta and a simpler thing. Any doubt in this? Yes or no? Then I will go to that delta to star otherwise. So we have to transform or transform between delta to star. So for delta to star, delta to star given is, what is given? R1 comma R2 comma R3. And what we have to find out? RA, RB, RC. Okay? We have given a component of delta. We have to find out component of star. Fine? Again, in this also we have a formula. And again, the formula is somewhat typical to remember. So, we will see how to calculate, how to make that formula. So, for converting delta to star, first of all, make an imaginary star inside the delta. Make some imaginary star inside the delta. Now, we have to find out RA. So, see, RA. RA is between R1 and R2. Right? You can see, this is RA. RA is between R1 and R2. So, in this, what will happen? Multiply the resistance between this exist, which means R1 multiplied by R2. Okay? Divided by summation of total resistance, R1 plus R2 plus R3. Okay? Similarly, RB. See, RB is of this branch, which means this is RB. So, for this RB is between R2 and R3. So, multiply R2 and R3. And divide by total resistance R1 plus R2 plus R3. Finally, RC. You can see RC is here. So, RC is between R1 and R3. So, multiply R1 and R3 and divide it. R1, R3 divided by R1 plus R2 plus R3. So, this is a simple formula to convert delta into star. Okay. Similarly, say some case also. Case, if R1 is equal to R2 equal to R3 equal to R, which means if all three resistors in delta are equal, then each resistor of star become RA is equal to 1. R1, R2 are equal. I can write R square. Divide by R plus R equal to R by 3. Similarly, RB, RC is equal to R by 3. This is the case. Okay. And same thing happen in case of inductor. So, I can write same for inductor. Same for inductor. Right. In capacitor, again, the formula will be formed like this one. The only difference is that we have to take a reciprocal of each capacitance. So, if there is a capacitor here, I am not forming a diagram. So, 1 upon CA, just like resistance, 1 upon CA, that CA between C1 and C2. So, 1 upon CA is equal to 1 upon C1 multiply 1 upon C2 divided by 1 upon C1 plus 1 upon C2 plus 1 upon C3. Like this. 1 upon CB is equal to 1 upon C2, 1 upon C3 divided by 1 upon C1 plus 1 upon C2 plus 1 upon C3. And finally, 1 upon CC is equal to 1 upon C1, 1 upon C3, C1 plus C2 plus C3. So, this becomes this. The same thing, the formula will form like the resistor and inductor. Just in case of capacitors, it will get reciprocal. Got it? Yes or no? Now, solve the question given the PPT. In this question, it is given a star network. Why network is a star network? A star network has resistance of 10 ohm each in two of its arm, while the third arm has a resistance of 11 ohm. In the equivalent delta network, the lowest value among three resistors is. So the question it is given, a star network has resistance of 10 ohm each of its 2 arm. Okay. So I have a star configuration, and in 2 arms I have a resistor 10 ohm, 10 ohm. You can take any arms, okay? And in 1 I have a resistor 11 ohm. So this is, I am getting RA, this is RB, this is RC. Now the question is, we have to find the lowest value among the three resistor in delta. Okay, so means basically we have to convert star into delta. So star into delta, I told you, what is the first point? First we will draw an imaginary delta over star. Like this, there is a pose of this branch, resistor is R1, for this R2, and for this it is R3. Okay. Now for calculating the R1, R1 is equal to, I told you, in case of star to delta, numerator will remain same, and it will be the summation of multiplication by taking two terms at a time. So it means R1 is equal to RA RB plus RB RC plus RC RA divided by, what is opposite to R1 in this network? Opposite to R1 is RB, so divide by RB. Now put all the values. RA is how much? 10 multiply by 11, 11 multiply by 10, 10 multiply by 10, divide by 11. So it will become 10 plus 10, 20 plus 100 divided by 11, 29.9 ohm. So R1 is how much? 29.9 ohm. Okay. Now we will see what is the value of R2. So for R2, see, for R2 I have a, again numerator will remain same, no doubt. RA RB plus RB RC plus RC RA. Now see, in opposite to R2 we have RA, so divide by RA. So again numerator will remain same, it become 10 into 11 plus 11 into 10 plus 10 into 10 divided by 10. So it will become 10 will cancel out from every term, 11 plus 11 plus 10, 32 ohm. Okay, and then find third one also, you will get the answer which one is lowest. Okay, so if we see the R3, check the calculation also, RA RB plus RB RC plus RC RA. Now R3, opposite to R3 we have a RC, so you can see both R3 and R2 will be equal. It is equal to 32 ohm again. Okay, so it means lowest is what? Lowest is 29.9 ohm. So the answer is 29.9. Now solve next question. Any doubt, anyone in this question? Yes or no? For this question, I am making the figure here. For next question. So the question is, consider a delta connection of resistor and its equivalent star as shown, like in figure. If all the elements of delta connected are scaled by a factor k, the element of the corresponding star equivalent will be scaled by a factor of. It means every element of delta is scaled by a factor k. Scaling means multiplication, which means every resistor here delta is multiplied by a factor k. Now the question is, how much multiplication or scaling will happen in case of star connection? Pooja, your answer is 1 by 3 times. So first option is 1 by 3 times. Let's see, it will be correct or not. 1 by 3. It means every resistor will scale by 1 by 3. Okay, Deepika, your answer is K by 3. Good. Boys, you should also try. So let's see. Now, how can we solve this problem? In this, the question is, every resistor of delta is scaled by a factor K. And now we have to check what will happen in a star configuration. Okay. So, see. First, I will draw imaginary star here. Okay. So, old values. First, I am talking about old values. Old values is nothing but this value, Ra, Rb, Rc. Now, if I want to find out the value of R1, see here, R1 is between Ra and Rb. So, the formula will be Ra, Rb divided by Ra plus Rb plus Rc. Right? Similarly, R2 is what? R2 is between Rb and Rc. It will be Rb multiplied by Rc. Divide by Ra plus Rb plus Rc. Finally, R3 is between Ra and Rc. So, Ra, Rc divide by Ra plus Rb plus Rc. So, first of all, this is the relation between R1, R2, R3 with the delta corrected resistors. Now, the question is, each resistor is scaled by factor K. It means now, Rb is scaled by factor K, it becomes KRb, it becomes KRc, it becomes KRa, KRc, KRb, KRa. Now we have to find out new star resistance. So R1 dash equal to, formula is here, KRa multiply by KRb, because the value is changed now, divide by KRa plus KRb plus KRc, right? Now, I can take K as a common from denominator. If I take K as a common from denominator and cancel 1K, I will left with KRa Rb divided by Ra plus Rb plus Rc. Now, Ra Rb divided by this term is what? This R1. So, new resistor R1 dash is equal to K times of old resistor. It means in case of star also, each resistor will scale by a factor K that you can see here, not by K by 3. So, tell me Deepika and Pooja, how you are getting K by 3 or 1 by 3? You can see here, each is scaled by a factor K. I took K as a common, cancel it, and we have left with only 1K. Okay, so the answer is K. So each will scale by factor K. We can again see in R2 also. R2 dash is nothing but KRb, KRc divided by KRa plus KRb plus KRc. Again, I can take K as a common. It will left with Rb Rc upon Ra plus Rb plus Rc. Now, this one is nothing but old value of R2, which is KR2. Again, it is scaled by a factor K. Okay? So, each and every resistor of a star will scale by a factor K if delta resistor is scaling by a factor K. Got it? Yes or no? So, if I see the option B is the answer. So, this was the star delta transformation. Again, when we will solve the question, there we will see the application of this. But for the homework point of view, I'm giving you this question, and this is an important question. Try to solve it. Okay, and everyone solve it. Everyone should try. Then I will tell you next class. So everyone, try to solve this question in the homework, and in next class I will tell you how to solve it and what is the answer of it. Okay, and I guess it is a question of GATE 2002. Write down the question only. This is a homework. Now, the next topic. Before starting the main topics, the last topic which remains is the source transformation. See, basically the question that comes from this chapter, 95% you will see the question come from the analysis part. For example, you have to use the mesh analysis, nodal, super mesh, super node. So all the things that we have done till now, that all the things will help you to analyze the network, analyze for the KVL, KCL. Okay, so all these things are gonna use in your analysis method. One small topic now is remain, which is the source transformation. And source transformation is very much important topic. Okay, you will see some books and all, the source transformation, they given only small part. But trust me, if you have a good command on a source transformation, most of the question you can solve easily. And if you don't have a good command, the question again can be solved, but it will take some much time. So source transformation is very powerful tool to analyze the circuit. So our next topic is the source transformation. Okay. So I hope you have not done the question. And try it in a homework. So our next topic is the source transformation. So as the name suggests, what is the source transformation? It means transformation of source, right? Normal in a layman language. So how many sources are present around us? We have only two sources, voltage source and a current source. Only these two sources we are going to deal in our whole subject. So source transformation means we have to transform either from voltage source to current source or from current source to voltage source. And then because of this, we can simplify our network. Okay. So source transformation is used to simplify a network, and it is a tool to transform a voltage into a current source or current into a voltage source. Okay. So let us start with a voltage to current source. I have a voltage source. Now, one important thing, source transformation, first point here, you should note down, source transformation is applicable only for the practical voltage source and current source. It is not applicable for the ideal voltage and ideal current source. Okay, note down this point, it is an important point. It is applicable for a practical sources only. And what do you mean by practical source? Practical sources, I have told you in our first lecture that it contains some resistor. For a voltage source, it contains resistor in a series. For a current source, it contains resistor in a parallel. Okay. So for a voltage source, I have voltage source in series with RS and a terminal in. Okay. So I have a voltage source. According to the source transformation, I can transform this into a current source. And what is the representation of current source? Simple. A current source in parallel to R. Current source in parallel to R. And this R is equal to the series resistor of a voltage source, RS. And the magnitude of current source, I, is equal to V by R. Means you can transform the voltage source into a current source in such a way the magnitude of current become V by RS and the series resistor of a voltage source comes with parallel to the current source. Okay. And if you want to convert current source into a voltage source, again, you can convert current source into a voltage source by placing parallel resistance series with it. And this voltage magnitude is nothing but I multiplied by RS. So if you talk about in a layman language, what is the current source? This is the source transformation. That in source transformation, we convert a practical voltage source into a practical current source and vice versa. Okay. Now the points arises. First point, how it will simplify our circuit. Okay, so first of all, I have told you, I have given you some statements in KVL and KCL. Out of this statement, there was a one statement I forgot to give. Write this statement, this is important. Number of KVL equation is equal to number of loops. That number of KVL equation of a particular network is equal to number of loop. Okay. Second statement. Number of KCL equation is equal to number of nodes minus 1. Number of KCL equation is equal to number of nodes minus 1. Write this 2 points. It is very important that in a particular network, number of KVL equation is number of equal to number of loops, and number of KCL equation is number of nodes minus 1. Okay. Now back to a source transformation. The question is how it will simplify the circuit. Tell me, anyone can give the idea. How will the source transformation simplify the circuit? Yes or no? Anyone? See here, when I transform into a from current source into a voltage source, see, this is my current source, I have transformed it into a voltage source. So if I transform it into a voltage source, you can see there is a one node, but when I transform it into here, the number of node will reduce by one. Okay. So from when we transform it from a current source into a voltage source, you can see that one node is now decreased. If one node is decreased, then number of KCL equation will also decrease. Why? Because number of KCL equation is equal to what? Number of node minus 1. And if number of KCL equation decreasing, means complexity is reducing. So remember this one point that I am going to tell, that whenever you get a current source like this, which means current source in parallel to resistor, always transform it into a voltage source. Okay, it will always simplify your network, because always the equation of current will be reduced by one. Okay, means whenever you get a current source like this, always transform it into a voltage source, because one node will get reduced and number of KCL equation will get reduced. It will simplify your circuit. But when you transform it into a voltage from current source, you can say when I transform voltage source into a current source, number of node is increasing. It means number of KCL equations increasing. But it doesn't mean it will complex the circuit. It depends on the network. So voltage to current source transformation is done according to a network. If network is simplifying, then we can convert voltage into a current source. But in case of current to voltage source, always transform it. It will simplify the circuit. And this source transformation is very important tool. Why? Because it will always simplify the circuit. For example, see here. Let's suppose this is some network. Okay. This is some network and the voltage source and two resistors are connected to each other. Like this. Now tell me, these two resistors, R and R, are they parallel? Yes or no? Tell me. Are these two resistors parallel or not? So the answer is I don't know the pronunciation. You said yes. Gaurav, you said yes. Ravi said not parallel. Pooja, no problem. Not parallel. And D.P. See. First of all, to check the parallel, to check whether the circuits or elements are parallel or not, I told you, you should draw the terminals. Means, see, for this resistor, there is one terminal here, there is other terminal here. For this resistor, there is one terminal here and one terminal here. Now, you should see that one terminal of resistors of both resistors are connected to each other. But second terminals are not interconnected to each other. And for two elements to be a parallel, both terminals must be connected to each other. And this is the best way to identify whether elements are parallel or not. You can see, if both terminals will be interconnected to each other, then it will be a parallel, otherwise it will not be a parallel. Okay. So first point is that R and R is not parallel. Now I want to apply here the source transformation so that this network will get simplified. So see how source transformation will get simplified. So before applying source transformation, you can see number of loops. You can see there is one loop, there is two loops. So number of loops, or I can say mesh, number of mesh or number of loop is equal to 2, and number of node. Tell me how many nodes are present of this side of a network. I'm not talking about this network of this side. Tell me how many nodes are present here. On the left side of a network, how many nodes are present here? Tell me. 2, correct. 2 nodes are present. Which one? This one and this one. So number of nodes 2. So it means KVL equation will be equal to 2. KCL equation will be 2 minus 1 equal to 1. So means KVL equation will be 2 and KCL will be 1. Now see, transform voltage source into a current source. So if I transform this voltage source into a current source, so voltage to current. So see here I will get a current source I of magnitude V by R, and the resistor parallel to it, this one. I have transformed this portion into a current source, okay, parallel, and this resistor, one more, will be here, and this is a network, right? Now you can see both resistors are come in a parallel form. You can see both terminals of the resistors are interconnected to each other. So now they are parallel. So now if they are parallel, I can convert this into a one branch equal to R by 2. This is V by R. This is network. Right? Like this. Now, this is a current source. So current source parallel to resistor. This is a practical current source. Again, I can apply the source transformation, which means first I have applied source transformation here. Now, second, I am applying the source transformation here. So, by applying the source transformation, become plus minus V equal to I multiply R. It means this current multiplied by R by 2, it will become V by 2 in series with R by 2. And this is the network. So now you can see in this network, number of loop is equal to 1, nodes is 0. So you can see KVL equation is how many? 1. So you can see here the total KVL plus KCL equation will 3. What's 3? Sorry. Total equations including KVL and KCL were 3. But here the total equation is only 1. So you can see the complexity of a network is reduced from 3 to 1. So this is the property or an advantage of source transformation, and this is very powerful tool. See, if someone is not as much strong in a source transformation and I'm going to give them this question, then how will they solve? They will apply here the KVL, here they will apply KVL and then solve it. They will get a right answer. But after so much complexity, complication. But if it knows the source transformation, then you can see we can easily convert this network in a simplified form. And here I can just write one KVL equation. Okay, so guys, source transformation, very powerful tool. You should know how to apply. Okay, and whenever you see this type of network, you can directly convert this into this one, in which two resistors which are not in parallel but of the equal magnitude and a voltage V, then that resistor become half R by 2 and voltage become V by 2. Okay, got it? Yes or no? Okay, good. Now we will see some conclusion from the source transformation. Okay, First, note down this one. Tell me, this type of circuit is possible or not? Yes or no? This type of circuit is possible or not? No. See, this type of circuit is possible if V1 is equal to V2. If it is not equal to, if they are not equal, then it is not possible. Because we know in a parallel branch, voltage are equal. So I can write here, V1 is equal to V2, then I can convert this into a one branch having voltage V. If V1 is equal to V2, then I can convert these two branch into a single branch. Similarly, this one. I have two current sources in series, but in a branch only one current can flow, right? So this circuit is only valid if both the current source have same magnitude as well as direction. So if I1 is equal to I2, then only I can remove one current source like this. Okay, this conclusion help you to reduce the network or reduce the complexity. Achha, Akif, you can say what is if polarity is opposite. It means you are saying if it is minus plus, like this. If it is a minus plus, then again this circuit is not valid, because in a parallel branches polarity as well as magnitude are equal. So if it is a minus plus, again the circuit is not valid. Circuit is only valid if V1 is equal to V2 by polarity as well as magnitude. Similarly here, the circuit is only valid if the direction of both the sources are equal. If the direction is opposite of one source, then again it will not vary. So first conclusion is that, second is this. Now third one, if we have a voltage source parallel to a current source. We have a voltage source parallel to a current source. So you can see, if we have voltage source parallel to a current source, then magnitude of voltage across this current source is fixed and is equal to what? V means, now for this particular branch, current is fixed. It will always be equal to I with same direction, and voltage is also fixed with this same polarity. It means in this circuit or in this branch, current as well as voltage is fixed. It means now I can remove this branch to simplify my circuit. I can redraw this diagram. Like this. Okay. So this conclusion will help you to simplify the circuit. You know, remember this three conclusion. This is simple that. In this branch, I know current and voltage can never be changed. It will always be same whatever the magnitude of this source is. So I can remove this branch, and with the same network, I can do our analysis. Okay? You can see, for example, let us suppose there is some branch, R1 also. Okay? So current flow here through R1, is fixed. It will be equal to I. This is one branch AB. Now you can see current flow in this branch is same. It will be equal to I. As well as voltage across this branch will be same. It will be equal to V. It means this across this branch, you cannot change the current as well as you cannot change the voltage. So you can see, if I remove this branch and form like this, then again the network is just simplified. This is the redundant branch. This time it is known as the redundant branches. So this will help you to simplify the circuit. So remember this three conclusion. And now tell me one point. In case of dependent sources, can we apply the source transformation? In case of dependent sources, can we apply the source transformation? Yes or no? See, this is the point that some students don't know. So, they always remember, dependent source, in case of dependent source, also we can apply the source transformation. Source transformation applicable for DC, AC and dependent sources also. For example, if I have a voltage dependent voltage source. For example, I have one source . This is my voltage dependent voltage source, okay? And here it is some network. Okay? Now, I can also apply source transformation in a dependent network. So, if I transform this one. So, first of all, it will change into a current source. And voltage dependent, current will also be dependent. Okay? Magnitude will be multiplication of these two. 2V multiplied by RS and then RS comes out parallel to this. This is nothing but a network. So you can see voltage multiplied by so 2V multiplied by RS. So it will give you what? It will give you the current voltage dependent current source. Okay? So see guys. If we have a voltage dependent voltage source, it will convert into a current dependent current source. It will divide. 2V divided by RS. Correct. 2V divided by RS. So, what I am saying, if we have a voltage dependent voltage source, it is converted into a voltage dependent current source. It means, in case of dependent sources, dependency will not change. If your original source is voltage dependent or current dependent, that transformation will also be the voltage dependent or current dependent. For example, this was the voltage dependent source. We have transformed it into a current source. It will become again voltage dependent current source. Okay. So in case of dependent source, we also apply the source transformation. Got it? Now, most important point for this topic. Limitation of source transformation, because right till now I have told you all the application of source transformation and the advantage, and also that you can apply anywhere. For example, I said one statement that if you have a current source, always convert it into a voltage source. Okay, but this is again the most important limitation of source transformation. Where should we not apply it? Okay. Because in any analysis you will see, it is easy to apply the analysis. But the most important point for any analysis or method is that limitation of it. Okay. So now we will see the limitation of source transformation or where we cannot apply it. Okay, let's see. This was the source transformation, just an example to convert current into a voltage source. Okay? Now see, let's suppose in the question, it is asking about the voltage across this resistor. It is asking about voltage across this resistor. In a question, it is asking about what will be the voltage across RS. Okay. Now, if I applied source transformation, that RS is now become the series component. But actually, initially, it was a parallel component. So, in case of parallel component, the value of voltage was different. And in case of series, the voltage will be different. So, always remember, if you transform some branch, means you are removing a branch. First, you have a parallel branch. By source transformation, you are removing that branch and including a series branch. So, never apply a source transformation if a branch is a dependent branch. Means, if our output our analysis are depending on that particular branch. Never apply the source transformation. You can only apply the source transformation if the branch is independent. For example, I'm giving you one question. One more. First part. Find current in 4 ohm. First part is this. Second part. Find voltage. Find current in 4 ohm. And second, find voltage in 2 ohm. Okay. First point, find current in a 4 ohm. Find second, find voltage in 2 ohm. So, first, we will do the first part. So, see. In first part, first of all, you can see the network. You have seen the network. Here, it is a current source parallel to R. It means I can apply the source transformation. It means if I change this into a voltage source, network complexity will get reduced. Okay. But check whether this branch that you are going to remove, or is this branch is depending or not, which means something our output is depending on this or not. So in a first question, it is asking find current in a 4 ohm, which means I have to find current in this resistor 4 ohm. It means it is not asking about anything of this branch. It means I can now remove this branch. So in a first part, if I am applying source transformation, it will become 2 multiplied by 2, 4 volt, 2 ohm comes in series, then I have a 3 ohm and 4 ohm, 3 ohm and 4 ohm, and now we have to find out I. You can see I is how much, there is only one voltage source, 4 divided by all the current, 2 plus 3 plus 4, so 4 plus 2 plus 4 plus 1, 9, 4 by 9 ampere. Answer is 4 by 9 ampere. Yeah, it means here I did apply the source transformation because this branch was independent. Nothing is depending on it. Okay. 1 amp, 4 by 9, I guess. 1 ampere is wrong. Now, second part is now we have to find out voltage across it. Now, if you remove this branch, like this one, if I remove this branch, the existence or the identity of this branch will remove. If you remove the resistor, the existence or identity of this will remove. Then how will you find voltage across this particular resistor? It means now I cannot apply source transformation. I have to use something else to find the voltage. For example, here you can see 2 ohm, 3 ohm, 4 ohm. Now I cannot apply the source transformation. I have to use something else. So something, what should I use? You can see we have to find out the voltage across it. So if I can find out the current, then multiply by resistance give you the voltage. 2 ampere current is coming in this direction. Now I have to use the current division rule to find out current in this branch I1. We can apply the current division rule. Why? Because this branch and this branch both are parallel to each other. So current division rule is what? I1. Remember the current division rules for two resistors, for two branches. For two branches, what is the current division rule? R1, R2, I. If I want to find I1, I1 is equal to current I multiply resistance of opposite branch, which is R2, divide by R1 plus R2. This is the current division rule in case of two branches. So you can see here, I1. Current coming is 2 ampere, multiply resistance of opposite branch. In this branch, we have to find it. Opposite is this. So 3 plus 4, 7. Divide by resistance of both branch. 3 plus 4, 7 plus 2, 9. So 14 divided by 9 is the current. Voltage will be 2 into 14 by 9, 28 by 9. So always remember, never remove the branch in source transformation if the branch is a depending branch. Okay. So the first case for depending branch is that, for example, if you want to find out output. Got it? Yes or no? Understood this one? What is the limitation of source transformation? Okay. So this is the first point. If the output is depending on a branch, then never remove that branch from the circuit. Second point. Now the second point is that if some dependent source is depending on this branch. Now the second point is, let us suppose in this question I'm changing someone. In this question, let us suppose I have a current source 2V. I have a current source. This is my voltage dependent current source. This is my voltage dependent current source. And you can see the magnitude of this source depending on voltage across 2 ohm. Magnitude of this dependent source depends on the voltage magnitude of 2 ohm. Now, if you remove this one, like this, then again identity of parallel branch will go. Then again existence of this will not exist. So it means if a dependent source magnitude is depending on any branch, we can never remove that branch from a circuit. Okay, so write the point. First point is, if output is depending on a branch, we never remove that branch from the circuit. Second point, if dependent source magnitude depends on some branch, then we cannot remove that branch from the circuit. Okay, got it? This is the only limitation. Or in other words, I can say, if the branch is independent, you can apply the source transformation, no problem. Okay?